So we have the founder and the CEO of Quantela talking about his vision towards the smart cities, towards the digital transformation. So we'll talk to him. He has a great vision towards converting these cities into a future cities, not over India in India, but globally. So let's talk to him. Thank you, Sridhar, for coming and talking to Economic Times.
Pleasure. Thanks for the opportunity.
So how is Quantela a part of future cities when I talk about globally, specifically about globally?
So as of today, we are part of 84 projects globally. So the biggest presence is in India, then US, when I call it Americas because Latin America is also big, Canada, then Europe. So our vision is to make cities, autonomous cities, reality, the way autonomous cars are. I'll just give you one example. Uber, right? It gives us such a seamless experience when somebody orders a car, the car comes to you. But from the digitization of the car, to make this happen, there is huge amount of noise. You see Uber documentary, there are so many strikes. Cities say that we don't want Uber, and there are so many messes, right? But the Uber solved all the problem through digitization and making it a very, very seamless experience for citizens to consume the car services, right? When you're working with the government, when you're trying to digitize urban infrastructure, there is a huge amount of human intervention, huge amount of policies. How do you bring this seamless experience for citizen to consume the government services? And government, using the digitization, how they can make urban infrastructure utilize more optimized, create more revenues, better citizen services. That's our vision.
So how has been your experience in India, specifically talking about smart cities or future cities?
See, when you say smart cities, you know, there are three things: economical, environmental, and social impact. India is a big success story because India, there is an organized smart city mission. And also at the same time, there is a huge amount of experience for us learning from India to take to the global. Before just give the experience, I'll tell you, because India is spearheading, there is opportunity for the startups here to take it to the global. You know, you have seen companies like Google, Uber, the global companies coming to India. But now there is an opportunity for the technology companies here to go global. I'll just give you one example. Kumbh Mela Mahakumbh, right? It's a smart city-led project, cities smart city, and crores people visited. So you have a video streaming where crowd management can be done, security can be done, everything has done fantastically, right? So now you think about, if I go with this technology to US or Europe or anybody, and I tell them, "Hey, this is a technology and which is proven with 60 million people," where will you get that level of size, proving your technology to that level of size? People really appreciate what you have done, and people want to partner with you. I think this is a great opportunity for us to learn here and take it global. And yeah, you coming back to India smart cities, our experience and learning, right? So when we started as a journey, we started simply a command control software. We have a dashboard and a policy engine. When cities are digitized, how you can operate those smart assets very efficiently and set the policies. So then we started learning. We started doing small pilots, then small projects, then larger projects. The first thing what we have realized is it's not about just digitizing the existing urban infrastructure. Because when you say smart city has huge amount of existing applications. It could be IT company applications like ERP applications, e-gov applications, municipal services. Then they have old SCADA systems. So it's about integrating IoT, OT, IT, and lots of open data. How do you integrate everything seamlessly into the platform? That's the first learning. So from a dashboard company, we become an Atlantis automation, which means we are extremely good at automating and integrating any kind of application into the platform better than anybody else, faster than anybody else, cheaper than anybody else. Now we have a platform which integrates everything into the platform. You can operate those smartly. Now, it's not just enough, right? You need to provide actionable insights for cities to operate those assets efficiently. That's where we built Atlantis recommendation, which means you take all those data and how you provide the cross-vertical intelligence to operate those assets. It could be parking, it could be lighting, waste efficiently. I think these learnings are very, very helpful. for us to design a future product which really fits into the market, at the same time taking it to the global.
So how is AWS and Quantela coming together towards digital transformation or urban transformation?
So AWS is our partner since inception. So entire our technology Atlantis is developed on AWS. So when you're coming back to India, what we have seen is initially lots of cities has gone from on-prem, but slowly, in fact, in between cities, communities and all this stuff, we are doing 47 projects in India, out of which now we see that lots of projects are coming in cloud instead of on-prem. So we see that around 35% of the projects are on cloud. So we are moving more and more towards the cloud. And how AWS helps in terms of, one is the multi-tenancy, where you have a state-level command control center and a city-level command control center, how you can optimize the infrastructure of AWS as a multi-tenancy between the state and central level, huge amount of optimization. And also, I think AWS policy of, they continuously work with you to optimize the cost. The sales guys are not paid for getting the more money, but sales guys are encouraged to optimize the cost for the customer, right? So they are fantastic in terms of more customer-centric, like us, the way we do. And what we have seen is the biggest challenges of executing smart city projects, the time it takes to complete the project because of so many integrations, because of readiness of the data center and all. With cloud, you can just finish everything in a few months and start delivering the value, because the citizens wanted to see the value faster. See, in smart cities, what happens is, it's like people ask me, hey, there's so many smart cities, I don't see any value, what's happening, is it on paper, right? If you're building a mall, right, if you're building a nice house, you need to have a foundation, you need to build the civil infrastructure, you need to build the interiors, and then you move, you get the value, right? So there is a step one, step two, three, step four. So that way, when it's cloud, you can derive the value, you know, much faster.
So when we say the cloud is a pillar of a smart cities or a future cities globally. But what are the challenges India is facing? How are they accepting it? What's the challenge? How can we overcome that? What are Indian cities still thinking? Why are they thinking about implementing these clouds? What's the challenge and how can Quantela and AWS solve that issue?
I think in the keynote, Teresa said that 7-8 years back when she started the practice, people used to have apprehension of, okay, cloud, is it secured? I mean, today people are saying, I would love to move because cloud is secured. I think the people perception is changing. Another big example is Urban Observatory, which Quantela, Cisco, AWS are big part of in terms of developing the technology and it's everything on AWS. So you can see that the MOUD mission, which is the umbrella of everything, is runs on cloud. So definitely acceptability is increasing and people realizing the security and how you can optimize the cost and the long-term advantages of it.
So do you think that cities will be able to adapt this cloud technology in the coming 5 years? The smart cities mission is almost now 5 years. So will they be able to adapt this cloud?
So I say the innovation, I compare innovation with cloud. Cloud is innovation, right? AWS is innovation in a new area. So I believe in one thing. Innovation, you overestimate short term, underestimate long term. If you look at Verizon, they wanted to predict how many cell phones will be sold in, let's say, next 5 years. So they got a number which was not impressive. And then they slowed down. Somebody else had entered the market and captured the market. So what I'm saying is, innovation starts slowly and suddenly hits. So it's a long term. It's, you underestimate, it just goes, takes off. I think it's going to take off.
So you won an award in Indian Economic Forum. You heard about Economic Forum, you won an award. What was that all about? What was your approach towards that?
So we have received an award as in technology pioneers globally for the industry kind of work what we have done. See, the difference what we have made to the society and to the smart city ecosystem, I think we are the only company which is a purpose-built platform for smart cities. We're not just an IoT platform, we're not just AI intelligence. We are here to solve customer problems. That's first. And unlike other technology companies, we say that customers are cities. Not always they understand the technology. So we are a technology company with a service now mindset. I will give a technology and solve the customer problems. I own that responsibility. Third, in fact, we are moving saying that, hey, we wanted to not only give the technology, we will not sell the technology, but we will sell the outcomes and take the value out of it. So we are moving into consumption-based model, outcome-based model, instead of selling the enterprise license. I think this overall the kind of impact which we have created. So we have received that global recognition, which is very helpful.
So you're talking about you solve the problems of your customers. What sort of problems are coming from Indian cities? What sort of problems and the challenges they are facing? What's the problem they tell you? Do you keep on interacting with them? What are the challenges or what are the problems you see in this city?
As I told you, country to country it changes, right? Major company, major places where economical, environmental and social. If you look at Europe perspective, you go to every city, you know, how do I help my old citizens to have a better health care? If old person, a retired person, you know, suddenly something happens to him, how do I diagnose, how do you make sure that he gets a medical treatment fast? If you look at India, I mean, traffic is a big problem, safety security is a big problem, and providing end-to-end all the citizen services to the citizen faster is, and this is where I think the India is, you know, focusing. So the opportunity, right, for cities, just look at this as an example. Let me ask you, who is the biggest real estate owner in the world? Cities. I'll tell you why. They have a stadium in the center of the city. They have a cricket ground in the center of the city. They have a park in the center of the city. They have a parking lot in the center of the city. And who is the poorest of all? Municipal administration. They always depend on the state government to fund them to provide the services. So there's a huge gap, right? So why? Because they are not digitized, they are unlucrative. And how do you digitize and bring them into the shared economy where more and more people can consume the services? And then once they more and more consume the services, first cities are happy because they are, that's what they are meant for. And they create more revenues. That money goes back into again, society to help the more and more people. And then environmental, right? Everything you do has an environmental benefit. For example, you do a smart lighting, which means you're reducing the cost of the power. Not only you're saving the money, there is a carbon footprint advantage. Let's say you reduce the traffic jams, you're reducing the pollution automatically. And let's take parking, right? When you do making smart parking, there is a 40% saving, 40% extra revenue generation because of the parking. Leaving that aside, 40% of the traffic jams happen because of you are waiting for, you are on a road, you're just looking for the parking, you don't know where the parking is, and 40% of the traffic jams happens because of that. And because of traffic jams, again, there is a pollution. So environment has effect on everything. And economic benefit is also has an advantage of to a citizen because all the money what you are getting, again, cities are going to put it back to the society of the people.
So the municipal corporation of metro cities like Delhi, Mumbai, they know everything. But there are tier 2, tier 3 cities who are also selected in smart cities. So do you think then we need to educate them about these solutions, these changes which can be brought with some small changes, small ideas or innovations?
Right. Absolutely. I think we have created something called Smart City in a Box, which becomes Smart City as a Service. So what we do is instead of investing huge amount of money, okay, these are the 5 basic solutions. This is the platform. These are the AI models which provide action insights to you. Start utilizing it. That's one. Second, cities should partner with the companies and with an SLAs to get outcomes so that you are focusing cities who doesn't have technology, who doesn't have the exclusive team. The company takes the responsibility of owning the actual delivery, right? For example, all the passports are outsourced to TCS and they manage, they're on SLA based. So like that, right, that's, I think these are the ways which small cities without the proper infrastructure, you can have a small package and cities part, companies partnership can flourish.
So you are the CEO and founder of Quantela. What is your role, the complete role in this organization?
So
what
sort
of decisions you take?
So I run the strategy and some part of business development. I'm extremely passionate about, you know, what we do is because there is a huge amount of social impact which you can create in the organization. So I read an article by Harvard Business School yesterday. It says that you need to have 2 careers, one which makes you money for your survival, then one for society. So I think we are in a situation where I have both together in one. So I drive this passion, I drive the future strategy, and we want to be leaders. We wanted to help cities to prosper, and we help through cities, citizens to have the better life.
Where do you see yourself after 5 years? 5 is a long time, 2 years I say.
So we wanted to be the world's best purpose-built smart city platform in the world and owning the responsibility of delivering the value. So when you look at smart cities, we don't want the buzzword and we don't want to take the share of it. We wanted to be the leaders and take the ownership to deliver the actual value which deserves.
Thank you so much for speaking to Economic Times.
Pleasure. Thank you so much for the opportunity.